What would you do if your human rights or somebody, the human rights of somebody you love were violated? So the right to free speech, freedom from inhumane treatment, the right to life. I think for me and most of the people here, we'd probably go to the police or the proper authorities. But what happens if the person or the individual that violated your human rights was part of the government or was the government? Where do you turn? So for countless individuals in Central and South America, this is their reality. And when justice has failed them in their national countries, they have turned to the Inter-American Court on Human Rights to file cases against their countries. And the court, in turn, rules on the case and issues a series of reparations that the country must follow in order to rectify the situation. And in many cases, the court has been extremely successful in helping these individuals, but in other cases, they've had hardly any impact. And so I set out to understand what factors influence the state's compliance with these reparations, given that this is such an important issue. So I started by running a multivariate regression, and I found that broadly, the two things that mattered the most were the content of the case, so the kinds of rights that the case includes, and then external pressure. And so that's where things get interesting. So external pressure goes in both ways. You can have external pressure from multinational corporations who are pushing for more lax regulations and going against human rights, but you can also have external pressure from the international community and other countries pushing for human rights, especially in non-democratic countries. And so this is all interesting, but I wanted to push past the data, and I also looked at four case studies to understand how advocacy from domestic organizations, international organizations, citizens can make an impact. And so one of the cases I looked at is Plan de Santos massacre versus Guatemala, which was a massacre that was perpetrated by the Guatemalan military in 1982. And in this case, Guatemala has actually admitted their responsibility for the case based on the court's ruling, and it has complied with around two-thirds of the reparations, which is significant. What I found through all of the case studies as a whole is that there is an impact for advocacy, and there's the highest rates of success when you see organizations that are united, when you see organizations that use a mix of different strategies, including protests, and when you see organizations that are working in conjunction with international organizations that are using their pressure to leverage these countries and improve compliance overall. And so what does all of this mean? Obviously, we can't make any impact on the content of the case, but what it does say is that individuals can have an impact. So an individual can use their own pressure to pressure a corporation, for example, to use corporate social responsibility, or they can support international organizations that do this important work in these countries. And so ultimately, if this happens, you can see that the court will become a stronger tool for victims, and that hopefully these countries will comply more with these reparations and stop future human rights violations going forward. Thank you.